First, though, I want you to take a look at this. This is a story coming out of Miami. Again, having to do with just how far police go in any particular case. This is just past midnight as you look at this video and you see these police officers who are coming to the scene. Now, you see that guy in a circle all the way at the top. He says something. Police respond. They go to the elevator, and that's when the violence begins. Watch this report as it's filed by Derek Hayward, one of my favorite reporters from WSVN in South Florida.
It is last December 5th, just after midnight, when young men get into an altercation and Fort Lauderdale police are called in. It is inside the lobby of this building, next to the nightlife of Riverfront. Joshua Ortiz is not seen fighting. He is in the elevator with his girlfriend, waiting for his friends to join him when he is confronted by police.
We just want to go home. What's your problem? And he's like, oh, yeah, you think I got a problem? And he gets very close to my face, like I'd say about here, and then pushes me into the corner of the elevator. And mind you, the whole time my hands are in my pocket, in my jacket pocket, the whole time when I was talking to them, when they proceeded to attack me, the whole time.
It's very easy for one to make a determination when they weren't present there. The totality of that video isn't shown there.
Fort Lauderdale police say the Internal Affairs Department has more of the video, and the department insists we are not getting the whole story.
You can clearly see Mr. Ortiz make a movement towards the officers.
And you, their response is justified then? The punch?
I won't sit here personally and say if the officer's response justified. That's why we have the procedures that we have here. Internal Affairs has deemed it to be appropriate at this point.
Joshua suffered a broken nose, and after being handcuffed on the lobby floor, he was charged with 5 counts of aggravated battery on a law enforcement officer. But the state attorney is dropping the charges.
Again, Derek Hayward out of WSVN in South Florida. For my money, one of the finest reporters in that market. Let me tell you something else.